Today, I want to talk about the learning styles myth. Hello and welcome to In the Classroom, an educational podcast making teaching and learning more transparent. My name is Benjamin Stewart at BenjaminLStewart.org, and today is July 9th, 2021. Before we get into today's topic, if you have any opinions, any ideas about what's being discussed today, if you want to share those, feel free to reach out to me at my Twitter handle at BNLEEZ. If you wish to be a part of the Discord community, you can access the link to that community by going to BenjaminLStewart.org. Today, I want to talk about learning styles. And there was a recent video that appeared in YouTube that really sparked this idea. I know in my particular case, I see a lot of students wanting to research learning styles. We have a course called Thesis Seminar, and it's very typical. In fact, it's common to have a few students always looking at learning styles or multiple intelligences as a topic for their research. And that's usually when we have a topic or a discussion, I should say, about really the feasibility, the applicability of pursuing such a topic when there is a lot of research out there that supports the idea of learning styles as a myth. Usually students come to this discussion with the premise that each individual student has maybe one or two very typical or common learning styles that work best for them in all situations, in all learning situations. And so then it's the role of the teacher to identify those learning styles at the individual level and then try to design a lesson or a task or an educative experience that accounts for those individual preferences or those individual styles. This is really the premise of this video that was just uploaded today to YouTube, where they basically say this is a myth. And there's other videos and other research out there that support this idea, but this particular video is a good one to start with. And in fact, I will include this a link to the video in the show notes. But it's I think it's worth mentioning to the learners that I come in contact with that if you're thinking about doing a study that relates to learning styles, perhaps instead look at it from maybe a performance aspect or maybe even an assessment standpoint, thinking of it as maybe looking at it from the perspective of a performance task or a project, or maybe investigating a problem. If we want to look at a problem-based learning, project-based learning, or performance task. And looking at each of these in terms of having an objective, maybe students are assuming particular roles, maybe there's an audience that's involved that is part of the project or the performance task. Usually there is a set of criteria that are being considered in terms of evaluation. There are typically a lot of decisions that need to be made on the part of the student and or the teacher in terms of the product, the process, and even the purpose of doing the activity. There's usually a context that needs to be explicit. And the idea here is that through this, these types of either performances or projects or pursuing particular problem and a solution activity, that the idea is that each learner has an opportunity to exercise some kind of visual aspect, a kinesthetic aspect, right? Then maybe they are including, it includes individual work, working with others. So there are different interactional patterns maybe that are going to be involved if you take the entire learning experience as a whole. And so perhaps maybe that's a different way of looking at it, where instead of thinking of it as individual set learning styles that are at the individual level in terms of each learner, that maybe it depends on the goals of the activity or the task or the project. And maybe there are certain activities that link together over time that incorporate these different ways of learning. So I wanted to bring this up because I know a lot of students, not a lot, but I would say several students, many, they're always in each group. There are a few that want to pursue multiple intelligence or learning styles, although that number has reduced over time. I wanted to share this video with you, share the sources, do your own research, look in the literature to see what others have done in terms of quote-unquote learning styles, and make your own decisions. Make sure that you're well-informed before you get into learning styles. And, you know, even from a practical standpoint, again, I'm thinking about Thesis Seminar, which is a 16-week course, which really doesn't give learners a lot of time to collect data. Usually, learners are limited to 2 to 3 weeks to collect the data. So in that particular context, usually when you're dealing with learning styles, it's not typically a good topic to pursue. So think about it. Take a look at this video. Talk with other instructors about your decisions if you're thinking about doing any kind of research that relates to learning styles, and try to make the most informed decision as possible. This has been In the Classroom, an educational podcast, making teaching and learning more transparent. Thanks for listening.